New jobs numbers are out this morning from Stats Canada. Tyler Orton with Business in Vancouver is joining us now with more on this. Tyler, what are we seeing nationally and for here in BC?
Well, it's very interesting because it's very clear that the reopening plan, that four-phase plan that BC unveiled earlier this year, it's having a palpable effect on job numbers here on the West Coast. Jobs are up, unemployment rate is falling sharply as the province moved into step two of its plan last month. If we take a look at the numbers, we can break it down. In BC, we added 42,000 jobs. Unemployment rate fell 0.4 percentage points compared with May. The big winners here, accommodation, food services, healthcare, social assistance, finance, real estate, insurance. But I will point out, construction took a big, big dip with more than 10,000 jobs lost. Canada also had big gains, though. We added more than 230,000 jobs across the country, and our unemployment rate also fell 0.4 percentage points. Now, look at it. Vaccination rates were surging right now. Case rates of COVID-19, they are falling. So that has allowed us to reopen and extend hours for restaurants and pubs. That cinemas and banquet halls, they're also operating at limited capacity of about 50 people right now. And intraprovincial tourism is permitted once again as of last month. That's why we're seeing big gains here. So there's going to be more to see as we move into phase three that happened this month. I'm very curious what those July numbers are going to look like. We'll know in just a few weeks.
Okay, sounds good. And also, BC's credit rating is taking another hit. Where do things stand right now, and why is this happening?
Well, we just found out that S&P Global Ratings has downgraded BC's perfect AAA rating to AA+ as of this week. Now, the agency says the pandemic's blow to the provincial economy and the decision to take on large deficits means that the province just no longer stacks up versus its AAA rated peers. So recall back in April, Finance Minister Selena Robinson, she unveiled the first budget since the 2020 provincial election, and it included a $9.7 billion deficit. So the move from S&P, it comes less than 2 weeks since Fitch Ratings also downgraded BC from a AAA to an AA+, also citing the province's deficits. Now, these ratings are very important. They affect the rates at which BC can borrow capital from lenders, meaning that we'll actually be charged at higher interest rates moving forward. So this makes clawing back deficits all the more difficult. So this is something that we're definitely going to keep our eyes on, especially as there's other provincial, or I should say credit rating agencies, that could have an impact on our rates moving forward.
For sure. All right, Tyler Orton with Business in Vancouver this morning. Thank you very much, Tyler.
Thank you, Sonia.